What's up guys, AT from G2M here, welcome back to the channel. I'm back after 45 long days without a single upload on the channel. So, new year, new career mode. We are going into manager career mode, and we are going to manage. Just a second, I'll be back. So I'm finally done setting up my manager. And yep, let's advance. So, as you all know, I am a big Real Madrid fan. If you don't know, yes, I am a big Real Madrid fan. We are going to take charge of Real Madrid. This is going to be a traditional 2 or 3 season career mode. So, yeah, you will see me playing games and everything. That's that. So, everything is going to be as is. 4 minutes of half-length time, legendary difficulty, euros. Euros as currency, European competitions enabled, yeah. Everything else, yeah, that's the same. And let's advance. So we are going to accept the preseason tournament invites. We're going to the Asian Elite Cup just for the extra cash. So we are in, and this is going to be our squad after the newest squad update. Well, in the attack we have Eden Hazard, Karim Benzema, Marco Asensio. That's the attack. And in the midfield we have Toni Kroos, Casemiro and Modric, the very experienced and elite midfield. I'll be looking to make some changes in the midfield. And coming into the defense we have Ferland Mendy, Sergio Ramos, Rafael Varane and Lucas Vazquez, who is not our traditional right back, so Carvajal will be joining us in the defense. And in goal we have Thiago Courtois. And coming to the bench, we have a few decent players: Vini Jr., Rodrigo, Fede Valverde, Lucas Vazquez, who I'm planning to sell. So Andy Lunin, I'm back with goalkeeper, and Nacho Fernandez, another player who I'm looking to sell. And Marcelo, I'll give him half a season and let's see. Yeah, and for the reserves, we have a lot of players: Isco, Eden Militao, Odriozola, Mariano, and the list goes on. I'll just transfer list a few players and show them to you. So before we do anything, just a second. Yeah, so before we do anything, I am going to negotiate Sergio Ramos' contract. So let's get into that quickly. I reckon that should be enough for getting a Sergio Ramos. Oh god damn it. He wants a lot of signing bonus. I mean, we could afford that, but what's wrong in being stingy? I mean, we could save money here and there, right? Yeah, that should do. I think that will wrap up Ramos' contract. Yes, and that's done. Ramos is going to stay here until 2023. That's cool. Guys, I just found out we have a gem of a player in our youth academy. It is Ricardo Chavez, 17 year old, 73 rated. Oh my god, this guy. Look at that potential as well. 83 to 94 potential. You know, the perks of pre-ordering FIFA. That's it. Wow, I mean, yeah. Now, let's get into some transfer business. So guys, these are the players I have transfer listed. Luka Modric, I mean, a beast of a player, a key player in the Real Madrid midfield, but 34 years of age, he's gonna go down massively in his overall, so he's gotta go, man. And Lucas Vazquez, 29, 80 rated. I mean, we have a ton of right wingers better than that, so he's gonna go. Mariano, 26 years of age, 76 rated. Not a great player to have. I mean, he's not that Real quality, so he's gonna go. And three other loan listed players. So yeah, that's it for the transfer listed players. Now let's get into some signings. Well guys, the first offer of a player who we're looking to sell is here for Luka Modric. Okay. 37 million for 34-year-old is reasonable, but let us see if we can get around 41 million or 40 million. You know what? I'll just accept that, man. Modric is a very great player, but still 34 years of age, we can't afford to have him. So, if everything goes through, Modric will be gone within 2 or 3 days. Guys, and that's official. Luka Modric has agreed terms with Borussia Dortmund and has left the club. So, it is time for us to find a new midfielder. And Fede Valverde is already in with a message. This is your chance. That's it. Cool. Guys, we have an offer for Casemiro, which I'm not interested in at all. How much of money you give me, I am not replacing my number one Serie A squad. So guys, we have signed Bernardo Silva from Manchester City for a hefty sum of 125 million euros. So, I know I've overpaid a little bit, just a little bit, but still. He's going to be a very solid player for us, that's for sure. And now, let's get into some development plan of his and, you know, first, let's change his position to a right winger. And that's going to take 2 weeks. And after that, I'll put him on a different development plan. So, yeah. Guys, so an offer coming in for Lucas Vazquez. 21 million. You know, I'm outright going to accept that from Osasuna. So, if it goes through, he'll be gone. Guys, another offer coming in for Lucas Vazquez, this time from Arsenal. I don't know why they want to sign another aging player who's not very good. Anyway, I just want cash. You know, Vazquez, you can go anywhere you want. Guys, we have got an offer from Tottenham Hotspur for Isco. You know, I am inclined to selling him if Mourinho is going to give us somewhere around 48. Mourinho, you give me that and you can take home Isco, man. Well, he'll give us 48 million, so. So guys, these are the players I have shortlisted to sign to replace Luka Modric in that midfield. Fede Valverde is 83 rated, you know, we can do with a higher rated midfielder. So, Fabinho from Liverpool, Bruno Fernandes from Manchester United, Paul Pogba from Manchester United, and Leon Goretzka from Bayern Munich. So, drop in your suggestions in the comment box down below. So, if you've enjoyed the video so far, leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, it's gonna help me a lot, man. So yeah, do that ASAP and share this video with all your friends, man, everyone, all the Real Madrid fans out there. So yeah, so let's get into the first game of the episode. So guys, Lucas Vazquez has been sold. Yeah, sorry, and let's get into the game. So that is going to be our team for this final against Ajax. And also guys, I have to sign a backup defender as well, so comment box down below. So yeah, this is going to be our squad. Eden Hazard, Karim Benzema and Bernardo Silva up top. Toni Kroos, Fede Valverde, Casemiro in that midfield, a strong midfield with Valverde's pace. And Ferland Mendy, Sergio Ramos, Rafael Varane, Carvajal in the defense and Thibaut Courtois in between the sticks, and that is the probable lineup for Ajax. Don't know which stadium we are in, but sure. Okay, Stadion Hanguk. Well, that is some Chinese stadium, I suppose. Daily Bim captains this side, Sergio Ramos for us. Well, the final. I thought of not playing the final, but you know, having a good look at the team, having the feel of the team is very crucial, so. And we had to play our first game in this episode, so. I chose to play this one. The game's underway. Karim Benzema with the kickoff. Okay, Hazard might be offside. He's not. Eden Hazard. Hazard shoots and scores. It is Eden Hazard.
Hazard.
And it's Hazard's third goal in this Asian Elite Cup. And find Toni Kroos. Toni Kroos shoots near post, and that's in. What is wrong with Onana, man? He is not able to save anything. And Kroos is going to come through the camera. Great. That is 2-0 up. Real. They have no power behind that shot as well. No power behind that shot at all, man. Kroos is an amazing journey. So 2-0 up Real Madrid. Chaos at the back. I don't know what's going on in the shots off, and he scored. It is Quincy Promes with the goal. I'm just gonna skip it, man. It's 2-1. Oh, what a save, but the rebound fell straight to Haller, and he scored. Well, that's 2-2 already. We have to bounce back. Yep, that is the first half done and dusted here at some random stadium. So we are currently in a very bad situation. Let's try and bounce back in the second half. So the second half is underway, looking to bounce back here and win our first silverware, even though if it's friendly. And that's a free kick given again. Maybe time for us to, you know, get in some substitutions, because Kroos looks absolutely tired. Sorry for that sound again. And Isco can play in that cam spot. And Militao will come on for Varane. Two changes for now. Nothing's gonna happen. We have to get in another attacker up top. Finds Karim Benzema. Benzema with now. Very big chance. Karim Benzema finds Isco. And Isco coming in and scoring a very crucial, potentially a winning goal for us. And Isco with his last game, maybe. Most probably his last game. Because we already accepted an offer for Isco from Tottenham. Let's see. Isco's most probable final goal in a Madrid shirt. And that's it, that's full time. We have won the cup. That's going to end off today's episode. We have won 3-2. I mean, it's a cup, man. It is still a cup. Friendly cup is still a cup. The midfield is missing something after Modric has left. So, yeah, put down your suggestions below for a midfielder and a potential second team centre back. You know, mid 70 rated centre back who is young, who can grow, centre back like that. So yeah, any centre back like that, comment section. I'll definitely go through each and every comment. So yeah, he's gonna lift the trophy there, and as soon as he lifts it, I'm gonna end off the video right then and there. So if you've enjoyed the video, drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel as I've already asked, it's going to help me a lot. And Fortnite content is soon coming to the channel, so stay tuned for that as well. It is AT here, until next time, peace. The light.